of discipline, less knowledge. But he who makes reproof is evil. A good man obtains favor from the Lord. A man of evil devices is condemned. No one is established by wickedness, but the root of the righteous will never be moved. And the Israelite wife is to be found with her husband, but she who brings shame is like rotten. Thoughts of the righteous are just, the counsel of the wicked is deceitful. The words of the wicked lie as he wastes the blood, but the mouth of the upright delivers them. The wicked are overthrown and no more, but the counsel of the righteous will stand. A man has commended according to his good sense, the one of twisted mind is despised. To be lonely and have a servant, and to play the grave man and lack bread. Whoever is righteous has regard for the life of his beast, but the mercy of the wicked is cruel. Whoever works his life lacks plenty of bread, but he who follows worthless pursuits lacks sense. Whoever is wicked covets the spoil of evildoers. The root of the righteous bears fruit. An evil man is ensnared by the transgressions of his lips, but the righteous escapes from trouble. From the fruit of his mouth, a man is satisfied with good, and the words of a man is comforting. The way of a fool is right in his own eyes, but a wise man listens to advice. The vexation of a fool is known at once, but the prudent ignores the insult. Whoever speaks the truth gives honest evidence, but a false witness hides it. There is one whose rash words are like thorns rust, and the tongue of the wise brings healing. Truthful lips endure forever, but a lying tongue. Deceit is in the heart of those who devise evil, but those who bless him, peace and joy. No ill befalls the righteous, but the wicked are filled with trouble. Lies are an accumulation of the Lord, but those who have faith in him are his delight. A prudent man conceals knowledge. A shadow of a diligent will rule, while a slothful will be put to forced labor. Anxiety in a man's heart weighs him down, but a good word makes him glad. One who is righteous is a guide to his neighbor, but if the wicked leads them astray, whoever is slothful will not roast his game. Diligent man and his precious wealth. In the path of righteousness is life, and in its pathway there is hope. This is the word of the Lord. Thank you. keyboard warrior who trolls the internet, trying to inflame online discussion. That is a profession to get into arguments, not merely because they want to seek resolution, because they need to be proven right in every argument, in open combat. Even if there's one, there are some points that is respectful for whose words are not really aimed to build up on the people, to think peace with other people, simply aimed at causing controversy or dissatisfaction and things of that nature. They'd be quarrelsome, just like that. Now, if quarrelsome voices would be, then so is gossip. I tell you what, there's a difference between gossip and slander. What's the difference between gossip and slander? I'll give you a couple of things. Thank you. Anything you say, but I don't really think that's anything to learn from anyone. So, not just speaking wise words to the smart money, because they're not going to be different to you anyway. So how do you speak wise words? How do you speak to the right person? the husband of the house. A good person has a good dress, brings forth good, and an evil person has an evil dress, brings forth evil. That's the same. On the time of judgment, people will give account for every careless word they speak. For by your word you will be justified, and with your word you will be condemned. Jesus said this is the same thing in the New Testament. Our words are a reflection of our lives. And so before these words that we have to speak in suggest that there is something wrong. And one day we will face God's judgment, said Jesus, for every careless word that you have spoken. Why does God take our words so seriously? After all, they're just words from my son. Well, it's because in many ways, we are like God in being able to speak. Have you ever thought about that? God is a speaker. Part of being made in God's image is that it's created us to be speakers. So the words that we speak can actually be quite powerful. But like God's words, sometimes we can use words to help people good. I mean, that's in fact words that you have to do things. When you look back on your life, you can think of certain words that have impact on you. But equally, words can be used to help me in ways that are uplifting, can't they? Proverbs 12, which we read today, describes all these words as sword friends. What are the words that have wounded you and destroyed you on the inside, so that even to this day, you cannot get rid of God? You want to see the verse of the enemy? Use those words. You will never do anything good. You are ugly. Why are you saying it? But it's not just that these words have been spoken to us. We gladly speak these words to others in ways that they can. And God says, one day, He will hold us accountable for every careless word we have spoken. If the problem with our words is really a problem with our hearts, what do we do about that? How can we give our hearts of wisdom? Well, we don't get wise hearts by just trying hard to be wise. We're not actually wise people to do such a find the wisdom we need to make our own. Look just within yourself and you'll find everything you need is the message we're getting in our world. But true. Right, so we gain wisdom by having come to God's wisdom. And His word, which is powerful enough to change our lives. And in Proverbs, you may consider that He's part of His six words of wisdom that we have to learn from. And in Proverbs chapter 1, that God speaks wisdom with a voice. Lady wisdom that we've seen over the last few weeks. And in chapter 2, verse 6, we are told, for the Lord gives wisdom, from His mouth come knowledge and understanding. So in the New Testament reading that we have today, that our wisdom says, what we really need is wisdom from the Lord. The kind of wisdom that God speaks from above to us. But even though God spoke these words of wisdom through Lady Wisdom and the voice of Solomon in the Old Testament, the New Testament says that in this God says, He speaks to us by His Son. For it is Jesus who is the greatest of wise teachers, isn't He? For He came into this world thinking what you're thinking. And exposing the inner which is the holy words that destroy our lives and destroy us. He's thinking in the right way, not harshly condemning us. For his holiness of speaking words of grace and mercy and things to the trust. For it was while we were still weak, at just the right time, that the apostle of Christ died. For you, we, in our nation, is faithful to Christ. And today, he speaks to you and me, and asks us to listen to him, to be changed by him, and to think that he's been blessed. Some of us, you know, quite quiet. We always lie for our own advantage. And we need to learn from a new one that Jesus thinks. So that's just an argument that Jesus makes, but we need to learn from the words of Jesus instead of peace, righteousness, and right. Some of us have got the words of slanderous, and we need to listen to Jesus who is a trustworthy friend. We need to listen to Jesus. He says that we have to be a people who can only boast in ourselves when we're in the gospel. Like the Lord Jesus. And that's why the Proverbs teaches us again and again about the value of the listening of the speaking. Did you notice that there's a bit of working away from Proverbs? Proverbs 16, verse 31, Proverbs. It's not just anyone says, the ear of the minister of sin is to be reproved, or to be reproved by the wise. When he says, listen to your ear, and expect instruction, that you may gain wisdom in the future. Well, if you speak less and listen more, Proverbs even says, you will be more intelligent than you ever are. Even a fool who keeps silence is considered wise. When he closes his lips, he's deemed intelligent. You see, the Proverbs tells us it is wise to listen. That's the reason why God gave you 2 years and 1 minute. The one who listens is the one who seeks to learn. Learn wisdom from God, and wisdom of understanding of the ones who have got that in a way, thinking they are better suited, they are looking to learn, they are wise in their own eyes. The ones who listen are those who know they need wisdom, and they need to be corrected by the words of God. And even in God's family, to be corrected by the words of others, in the family of God. Why is it possible to learn wisdom on your own? And it is truly true that we can express. But those who are committed to church and coming regularly to church, learning from the Word of God, and listening to the wisdom of others, who know a thing or two about life because they're further down the track, well, it is those people who generally grow in wisdom. Whereas those who come to church once a month, when it kind of suits them, I'm not talking about people who just can't get to church for the things that I'm talking about. I think too rainy today, quite good. Because those who generally are just the price of their own lives, they do not grow in business, they do not grow in resources. What are you doing? What do your words reveal about you? What do your ears reveal about you? Do you listen? Do you listen and accept correction from God and from others? When was the last time you listened to on the outside, can you remember? When you listen to God's word and change something. Because you thought, actually, oh my God, what's really making things different? The wise one is the one that listens to what he listens to. The wise one is the one that has been learned. The word that we speak, and that it changes us more into the image of yourself. And Father, we acknowledge that we are people who often speak in foolish ways to the detriment of others and ourselves. And we ask for your forgiveness. Father, we thank you for our Lord Jesus who was in us. He was not speaking in mouth, he did not have the mind. Wisdom.